Lakers center Christian Koloko has yet to be cleared by the NBA's fitness to play panel, but that doesn't mean that he's not working out. In fact, he's been working out with former Lakers big man JaVale McGee. The two recently had a three-on-three contest, one that JaVale calls the greatest comeback in three-on-three history, while Koloko says that McGee cheated. Who's right? Take a look. This is from JaVale McGee's Instagram account showing footage of the three-on-three contest between the two. Both guys 7 feet tall, JaVale with a 7'6 wingspan, 7'5 wingspan for Koloko. You know, what's really apparent in this, JaVale is about 40 pounds, at least listed as 40 pounds heavier than Koloko, 230 for Koloko, 270 for McGee. You can see it. Look at how McGee is able to kind of bully Koloko a little bit there in the post, get contact, and Coloco's not able to stick with him. But then you can see the athleticism from Koloko. You can see the quickness comes into play. But McGee has got the post moves, the spin, the soft touch there. Remember, this is from McGee's Instagram account, so we're going to see some good highlights of him. But he even has the fadeaway right there. Here's Christian Koloko firing back with a dunk. McGee, again, though, takes Koloko into the post and then just uses his size. He's got the extra 40 pounds on him, and that's apparent in that situation. But here's the questionable spot here. Koloko hits a three, which that's something we need to talk about, and is called for a travel. Now, Koloko says that McGee was cheating, and that's what allowed them to win the game because that three was called off. Now, is he right? Is McGee right? Was it a travel? Let's take a look. Here it is in slow-mo. Here's the catch. One, two, three. He puts the foot down. Christian Koloko shoots the three. Let's go back and look. Replay that one more time. So Christian Koloko, he's saying this isn't a travel. I think this gets into kind of the gather step stuff. Like, does he have the ball right here? If he technically has possession, I would say yes, he does. Then there's a step right there. He's got a foot down. If we're not counting that step, though, then it's one, two, and he's fine. So I'm more old school in terms of my interpretation of the rules. I would say, yes, that's a travel. I'll tell you this, though. There's no way in hell that's getting called in an actual NBA game. They're not calling that as a travel. They're just not going to do it. We've seen it. The interpretation of traveling rules in the NBA have gotten looser and looser over time. I just don't see any way they're actually calling this as a real travel in a game because it's so close as is. Again, are you counting that as a step or are we counting that as the gather step, which we've seen more and more? If it's the latter, then it's fine. It's not a travel. And that getting called as a travel, it's pretty questionable at best. So Koloko says JaVale McGee cheated to win this three-on-three game. And McGee says, no, it was an amazing comeback. Now, I think there are some actual key takeaways from this game. And it's more than just, you know, whether or not this is a travel. And here, I'll throw it back up there for everybody while we're going through this. More than whether or not this is just a travel, there's a few key takeaways from this. Number one, JaVale McGee looks pretty damn good. Again, I keep going back to, if only the Lakers had a roster spot right now, because JaVale, we saw him in training footage the other day, and he looks pretty damn shredded. This guy is in shape. And you could see the difference that it makes here with Christian Koloko, just the extra size that he's got. Christian Koloko, when he's on the floor with Anthony Davis, AD is the bigger player. AD's 250. He's got more bulk to him than Christian Koloko does. JaVale McGee, that's not the case with. That's why with the 2020 team, JaVale, when he was on the floor, he was clearly the center. When Dwight Howard was on the floor, he was clearly the center. There's no one on the Lakers roster, including Christian Koloko, who is 100% clearly the center if they're sharing the floor with Anthony Davis, just because AD is still the biggest player on the floor. Now, can Koloko defend fives? Yes, but you also see just a 270-pound JaVale McGee, the difference that that makes. So imagine if he's trying to defend Nikola Jokic, Yusuf Nurkic, some of the other big bruisers in the NBA. I'm not saying Christian Koloko is a bad signing by the Lakers or a bad guy to take a gamble on. Absolutely not. And I have a feeling if we were looking at the Christian Koloko highlights of this video, of this three-on-three game, and not so much the JaVale perspective, we would see him doing even more athletic stuff. There is something that being a little bit lighter gives him in terms of his athleticism. And so I think that's something that's important. He's going to be more explosive. That said, JaVale McGee was an incredibly explosive player. Now, he's also 36 years old, but my number one takeaway from this is, man, I mean, JaVale sure looks like he's still playing at a fairly high level. Now, again, this is far from an NBA game where you have to rotate, read defenses, and all that kind of stuff, but JaVale does look like he's in pretty good shape here. Now, the other thing is Koloko, again, you can see the shot blocking. You can see the athleticism. It's important that he's out there and he's training. That's another takeaway, is he's getting in work against NBA caliber players, or player in JaVale McGee, a true big in JaVale. That's what Christian Koloko is battling against in these workouts. That's important. Whenever he finally gets cleared, he's not going to come into the Lakers with zero experience under his belt, having not played in the last year and a half or whatever in an actual NBA game. It's not like he hasn't been playing against NBA talent. And that's going to be the case here with JaVale and Christian Koloko getting in these workouts. And then the last thing, whether or not it was a travel, it doesn't really matter so much. The fact that Christian Koloko is taking and making a three, that was something that was not really part of his game in his prior stint in the NBA. I don't know if the three ball is going to become a weapon for him or not, but if it does, that only increases his usefulness in the NBA. If that is a shot that he can now take and make with any kind of consistency. Now, I don't want to get ahead of ourselves. Guys take shots in practice all the time that they're probably not going to take in a game session. Dwight Howard famously would use the three-point shot as part of his warm-up routine before games. Fans would see him draining threes, and people would say, why doesn't he shoot these in games? It's a very different environment in a workout situation, even an informal three-on-three like this, to be taking a three versus shooting one in an NBA game. But nonetheless, maybe a little bit encouraging that he's actually taking a three-pointer in this three-on-three game. Perhaps that's something he's added. I don't want to jump to conclusions, but something worth keeping an eye on now that we're seeing him take that shot in a training session. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comment section down below. What do you think about this three-on-three battle, Christian Koloko against JaVale McGee? And do you think it was a travel? Is JaVale right that it was an amazing comeback, or is Koloko right that McGee cheated because he didn't travel on the shot? Give me your thoughts in the comment section. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.